Any other questions? We kind of paid for some POs. There are different ways. Can I wrap it up in a kind of a quick summary? Mm-hmm. We're going to go right here, okay? So POs you can do, there's basically three different ways you can pay for POs, okay? One, if you go home and you go to your payables homepage, you can pay in bulk. See this line that says POs? This is paying for things in bulk, okay? You click on something, and you literally can go click, click, pay, okay? The problem there is you only get one chance to assign it to a type, okay? But this is very fast. I could literally pay out 20 by going like this. Click, 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 pay, okay? I already know the vendor. It's going to do all the math. I can do sub partial payments pretty fast, okay? My limitation to this is I only have one expense type. So what's this? Click, click, pay. It builds the whole thing, but I only get one of these guys to assign it to a type.
When you do the click, click, pay, those are all the same vendor.
Correct, correct, okay? Now, this is one way to pay. This is kind of bulk. It's right off the payables homepage, okay? The other two ways to pay for a PO actually deal on the expense side, and it's almost by a line item by line item or a little custom builder piece, okay? So check this out right here. Bowling Supply and Clothing, Inc., we owe them two of them for a total of $3,000, okay? Here's the $3,000 that we owe them. Looks like $2,000 actually already got paid off on this original piece right here. Now I literally can go like this, click, click, pay. Like I have no clue if there's any freight on them. That's where the prep comes in to check to see if there's any freight, and that would be very quick to pay for those. You know, we actually have a ton of payables. Let's pay off a couple different things. What I'm going to do right here is watch this. Let's go back to just one level deeper. Here's our payables homepage, okay? Look at all these things that I can pay off, okay? Let's go through a few of them and just kind of have some fun. So here's the bowling one. $5,000, it paid $2,000, we owe $3,300, okay? Click. Here's one way to do it. From the payables homepage, as long as it's verified, I have options, and I can go click, click, pay. I can come down. I can say this was a check. Bank. This is the bank. Whatever you wanted to do for your thing, you come down and you say inventory. Click, create that receipt. What it did is it gave me a new receipt number, and it tied those two POs, 44 and 47, with the correct payments, so everything's happy and satisfied, okay? That's one way to do it. Here's the other way to do it. Let's go find somebody that we actually owe money to again. So we're going to go home. Did you have a question?
Yeah. When I did that click, click, pay, I made it into an expense receipt, but then I have to go one step further and actually write the check.
Okay, perfect. Like, literally, it's this easy right here. Okay.
Okay.
Do you want to put in a check out or
do you want? We've already seen you do it. But okay. I was just saying, even though we would click, click, hey, we still have one more step to actually get it up.
Correct. Good call. Absolutely. Good call. Okay, so what we're going to do now is I'm going to go back to the payables homepage. We're going to look at somebody else. You can notice that top one totally dropped off our radar, if you will, because they're totally satisfied. Here's one that has a whole bunch. Let's go XYZ Bowling Warehouse. We'll take a look at it. Oh, it only has one little item that it's kind of looking for, okay? Let's see if any of these other guys have anything else. That's just one. Oh, this one has two. Pro Bowling. We were in here playing. This is actually us playing, okay? So currently this is where we were before. Click, click, pay. This one won't let you because it says not yet. You'd have to verify it, okay? Watch this. Let's go find this particular bowling supplies company. So watch this.
So you mean the verified is really, even though I got a receipt in, someone has to say, yeah, I really got this.
Okay, all it does is it's kind of like a little check, if you will, to be like, should I really pay for this? Okay, yes, I should really pay for this. Okay, like, and it's designed for multiple users to play and coordinate and talk to each other. If you're just a one-person thing, like, oh my goodness, that's an extra step that I have to do, okay? The third option, when I show you how to do the third option for paying a PO, I will show you how you could technically skip the verified piece and not even worry about it.
Okay.
Okay? So watch this. what I'm going to do now is instead of going click, click, pay, we're going to go over to the expense receipt part, and then we're going to start paying, playing with the different things. This is more of a manual process, but it's a way to pay for a PO. Okay? So technically, we owe these guys $368. Okay? Watch this. I'm going to go vendor. I'm just going to type in this right here. Pro, because this is what it's, I'm looking for, the Pro Bowling Supplies. Hit go, and I'm going to say I'm going to do a new expense receipt. How much do I want to pay them? I owed them, what, $300-some-odd? Like, ideally, if you run off your payables homepage, your numbers are there. It's all categorized already for you. But this is kind of breaking into a little bit different scenario. I can't remember how much we're going to pay. Let's pay $200, okay? So it's going to be kind of a partial payment. Okay, if I know the physical numbers, I can write them in here. I don't, so what? Here's what I'm going to do. Skip this whole section. This is where it says to do this. So skip the section, leave all the line amounts blank, okay? So I just killed that little piece right there. And I'm going to come down, and eventually I'm going to create a physical check for $200 to them, and I need to put in my check number. Click. So technically, an expense has three different parts, a main, line items, and the payments. I have the main, I have absolutely nothing in the line items, and I have my payment, okay? But what I was going to try to do is I was going to try to use this little guy. This is a smaller little subsection of the payables, and I can kind of like come back and forth and kind of dictate it a little bit differently versus instead of filling out the whole expense receipt information like on the other one, I literally could be like, I'm going to pay for this whole thing, and this one's going to go towards inventory. Click. Okay? I could come right back and cycle right back around and say, click. Oh, looks like I can't do anything. I better quick verify that one. Verify it. Go. Click. So I'm right back here. I'm like, okay, I can't even remember how much I paid on that last one. My bad. Let's just go to the edit line items for just a second. Okay, I apparently overpaid this. Okay, no problem. So maybe I could only have paid partial on this one. So I need to modify this. I didn't even look, okay? It's kind of in a hurry trying to show you what it was doing. Let's back that out. I'm only doing 500 on this guy. Click, click, click. I might need to even change my information, okay? So, sorry, I have to edit it one more time. But if you're using the automated piece, it automatically pulls in a bunch of information for you, okay? Edit that line item. So now it's $200. It's happy. I have one line item. I actually was only paying for a portion of one. And then here's my check that actually goes out, and I would click print, okay? But technically, PO 51 will get attributed this $200 tied to expense receipt number 55. Okay, so if I click on this, just so you can see it, payments. Okay, looks like we actually had done another expense for this particular one as well. Okay, so its original value was $499, and looks like we paid a total of $600, but only $149 of that original one went towards it, and then $200 went towards it. So what we owe still is, this is the total paid, this is the total amount owed. Okay, the other way that we can do it is let's go, I'm going to actually pull up the same vendor again. Actually, we're right here. Let's go edit line items and click on payables. What do we still owe for this person? So if I know a specific number and I want to attribute something, see this PO 51 and I owe $150.85? If I know PO number 51, even if it's not verified, I could technically pay it off, okay? Like all the other ones, you know how the check boxes wouldn't show up if you were unverified? Just for testing, I just want to show you this right here, okay? Click. So currently, I couldn't even click this little check box here because it's not verified. Mm-hmm. But if I know the number 51, and say I even know an amount, I have paper or I have something in front of me, I'm just going to copy this amount right here. I'm going to actually go pay for this without even verifying it, okay? Let's go create a new expense receipt. I didn't mean to go vendor new. I meant to go vendor pro. created an expense receipt. I'm popping down through here. This is how much I was going to pay. Paying for PO 51. So watch this. I know that 51 is not even verified right now, okay? But if I come down here, I can attribute to whatever I want, or even splitting little different pieces right here at one time. So this is just for fun, and this may not totally answer your question, but watch this. Say I go 125.85 is inventory, PO 51, and the other one is 25 towards freight for PO number 51. See how I'm putting them in different little types right here? There's lots of different ways that you can pay for POs. This is manual. I had to physically type this number in here. I don't even know if 51 actually has any freight on it, but I just was showing you how the manual process, if I put the number in right here, even though this isn't verified, this $150.85, which is split between two line items, would technically go right through no problem. Click the location on the second one, or on both, S and S. Okay, it was wanting a little bit more information. I was just able to pay for 51, even though it was not verified. So if I click on it, it'll now probably say that because it got paid, it'll actually mark it as verified. But if you watch this right here under history, okay, click, 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 use the verify to unlock the PO. Oh, I marked it as paid, see expense receipt number 56. I'm going to go ahead and verify that for you because I know that you paid for it. Okay, so it kind of wrapped all of those different little pieces up together. That's the PO itself. We're going to come back here. We manually typed that in there, and it still allowed us to do it. So we have the bulk thing from the payables homepage. We have the little builder link if you go to an expense, and then you want to use the little builder, which is kind of a quick little way, or you can manually type it in. The manually typing it in way, you could technically have a vendor for Pro Bowling Supplies, and you could potentially pay somebody who's XYZ Bowling, okay? All of the manual ones where we go click, click, pay, click, click, pay, the vendor on the PO has to match the vendor on the expense receipt for the automated process to work. But if you ever have anything that's split, oh, I'm entering generic items, so they were under PO for this thing, but I actually owed Johnny, you could potentially use the manual one to kind of put it into play. Okay? Cool, we've spent a ton of time on POs. Basically what it is we're dealing all right here in this little teeny area, okay? This is kind of dealing with POs and how we're paying with them. It all kind of comes down to what happens in your payables. How do we want to play with this, okay? Do we want to manage the payable on the PO side, or do we want to manage the payable on the expense receipt and or split side, okay? They still all connect right here with our vendor waiting room, our payables. Okay.